of you. Now today we will see one activity is given to you. Try this. The teacher should make two groups of the students in the class. The first group should do the following activity under the supervision of the teacher carefully. We have to make two groups of the students. So the first group will do the one activity as shown in the figure 3.5. Okay, that is 3.5. What we have to do now? Take water in a pressure cooker. Generally, we are using the pressure cooker in the making of the food. No, so that we have to take pressure cooker. Take off the whistle of the pressure cooker. So whistle is there now. So we have to remove that, and then now heat the cooker. So what we have to do? That we have to start heating the cooker. Actually, we are heating the water. So take a lid with the handle. Okay. So take a lid with the handle as shown in the figure. Because you see how the lid is in this position. You have to keep the lid after boiling the water in the cooker. So after the water starts boiling, hold the lid at a distance from where the steam is coming out. So near to that mouth of the cooker, okay, where the steams or vapors are coming low. So you just keep in this position the lid of the cooker. So observe what happened. So after, you must have observed that water changes into water vapor after it was heated. So when we are heating the this water, so it start the water start turning into vapor, and as soon as it touches the this lid, okay, as we know that the lid is cold, okay, it is cool in the area, is cold. So when it comes here, so start the formation of the drops of water here. Okay, so we just the vapor which are hot, and they, when they touches the lid, the there is a formation of drop. Okay, so in short we can say that the area from hot area to the cool area, there is a formation, water vapor turns into water, okay, or droplets of water. So this vapor turns into water droplets when it touches the cooler lid. We can see the water droplet deposited on the lid. Okay, so this is the first activity. Now, what is the second activity? The second activity, the other group should carry out the following activity as shown in the figure here. Okay, so you have to take a glass with flat bottom. Okay, you have to take a glass with flat bottom, put some ice cubes in it. Okay, so we have to put some ice cubes in the that glass. Then keep this glass in a room for about 2 to 3 minutes. So after keeping the cubes or ice in the glass for 2 to 3 minutes, you will observe. What do you see? In some time you will see droplets of water on the outer surface of the glass. So you see here the droplets are appearing here on the outer side of the glass. Okay, after 2-3 times when the ice are kept in the glass. So when the water vapor in the air comes in contact with the cold surface, condensation takes place. So as we know that outside nothing was there, only inside the water ice cubes were there, but you know that in the atmosphere vapors are there, means okay, water vapors are there. So as soon as they comes in the near the or on the near the glass, okay, on the surface of the glass, so they touches the cold area of the glass, and hence the droplets are formed. So in the first activity, the steam from the cooker cooled, okay, and condense into water vapor. So from in the first case, in the water vapor from the hot area comes to the cold area, it turns into water droplets. In the second activity, the vapor in the air, okay, when it touches the cold area, okay, when it from warm area to cold area, so the water droplets are formed. Now next is the condensation, densification and sublimation. Now we will see what are they. So condensation, the process of changing of water vapor in air into water is called condensation or densification. So both the terms are same, condensation as well as densification. What are the fun one? Once more, we will repeat: the process of water vapor in the air into water is called the condensation or densification. Also, the process of vapor gas changes into solid state is called sublimation. Actually, the definition of sublimation is that the process of changing of solid into directly into gases without converting into liquid is called sublimation. Okay, the process of change of solid into directly into vapor without going the process of liquid, it's called sublimation. For example, you see that naphthalene balls are there. Okay, so directly they change into gases form naphthalene. Okay, that or Dambar ki goli we say in Hindi. Okay, so that is sublimation only, turning of solid gas form directly from solid in without changing into liquid, that is sublimation. So if the temperature of the air reduces, its vapor holding capacity also reduces. So when the temperature of the air reduces, its vapor holding capacity of also reduces. When relative humidity of the air becomes 100%, vapor start condensing. Okay, so vapor start condensing. When the, already we have studied about what is relative humidity, what is absolute humidity. So at this time, the temperature of the air should be at dew point. Okay, so what is dew point? The dew point is that nothing but that holding of the water vapor. It cannot hold, the temperature cannot hold more water. So that is the temperature of, you can say that is the dew point. It implies that for condensation, temperature should be low. Okay, so for condensation, the temperature should be low and relative humidity must be high. In the free environment, condensation of the vapor in the air occurs around fine particles like dust, salt, etc. in the air. So in the free environment, condensation of the vapor in the air occurs fine particles around fine particles like dust, salt, etc. in the air. Now dew, okay, dew, you know that dews are occurring on the droplets are occurring on the leaves. Okay, we say the dew, frost is there. Okay, and the fog are the forms of condensation at ground level, while clouds are a form of condensation at higher elevation. So we will stop here. Thank you.